Now I want to introduce you the hardware which we will use for our hands-ons, and it's the STM32 Nucleo. In my case, I will use the STM32F401RE Nucleo board. And what we can find on this board? On this board, in the middle of the board, we can find the STM32F401RE. But there are also other components. Then we can find here the blue button, which is connected to the PC13, and we can use it for our applications. The black button is the reset button. In case that you want to start the program again, you can press the reset button. And then is the green LED, which is connected to pin PA5. On the left and right side, there are also headers. There are connected all three pins of the microcontroller. They are directly connected to these headers. Then you can use it to connect your own application, your own external devices, or you can connect here our extension shields. There is also the second line of the headers, where you can connect the Arduino extension add-ons or also our XNucleo extension shields. On the top part of this board, you can find the ST-Link debugger, which also can work as a masterage programmer when you drag and drop the binary into this masterage which appear in your system, and it will automatically program the STM32. There is also the virtual COM port bridge between the USB and UART, which is directly connected into STM32F401. And the main part is the debugger, which can be used for the programming or debugging of our application. It's run over SWD interface. Don't forget, not over JTAG, over SWD. And you can also connect the external devices. If you unconnect these two jumpers, you can use this connector to connect any external STM32 microcontroller where you need to use some pins of this header, mainly the clock, SW clock, the ground, and the SW data. This is the minimum setting. We recommend also to connect at least the reset. And the last part, how to connect this board to your PC. For this, we use this USB connector. In my case, it is mini USB connector. In case that you have STM32 Nucleo board with 32 pin, or the 144 pin Nucleo, you will have the micro USB connector. The board is also powered from this connector, then it must be plugged into your PC all the time. If you want the better description of the all your features and also schematics, you can find it in the user manual from the Nucleo, which is on our website. It's called the UM1724, or here in the external link is the link on our website where you can download this manual.